I play around with the mechanic for the tilt. And I think I find a way how I want to do this. That's just a test. So I use this sled, but I want to install this instead of this on this place. And I make another bar for reinforcement. And I mount this block on this bar. So all it's strong enough. And this I make longer ones. I will using. And for the sled, I have made this sled for the side normally. But I want to use the sled for here. I drill a hole. I glue and screw this here, and I have the sled with for the threaded rod. And so if I turn here, the sled goes this way. And for coming in the front, I think I make some gears just for test. How it works, we will see. This is what I'm going to do in this video. Here is the top side from the sled, from the tilt mechanic. Now I have to mount this sled on here, like so. And I have to cut for the same thickness. And also I have to drill a hole in the same place where are the nuts for the threaded rod have a place to go. That's a little tricky because I actually glue and screw this on this piece. Yeah, it's not easy. I will see. And the other holder is glued on the bar. And this I screw on the side from the table saw carriage after. I cut the carriage on the bandsaw, a small place. And now to mark how I put the hole, I think I use a drill bit. And line this up. Give a tap. So now I know where I have to put the hole. And to get this off, I think I loosen the screws and cut this off with the bandsaw to bring this in the drill press, because I cannot drill so far. So to get the hole straight, I mount this with a clamp on a flat block. So now I can glue and screw this back in place.
Oops.
And for line up, I use this one. Find out where are the holes for the threaded rod are coming. So I post this in the right place, direct in the center, and I use again the drill for marking where I have to put the holes. On both sides. Before I finish the tilt mechanic, I have to close the gap between the dust hood and the table saw top, because I don't want any sawdust in the inside from the table saw. So, and for do this, I have nothing special in my shop, and don't forget, the table saw is just a prototype, so I can improvise. And for making this, to close the gap, I use duct tape. One day I have made a wallet from duct tape. It came out very well. You know this? Oh. I think duct tape is sturdy enough. And it bends and I think it's okay. So, and I think how I get this on, I think I glue this with epoxy, like so. And after I screw a piece of wood, and that I make around, and after on the table saw top also. So. And this, I think, close all the gaps. And mount it back in place. For the moment, I don't know, I fix this also on the tabletop. Because after I have to do the cross-cut sled slot from the top side. And maybe the screws are in the way. I see after how I do this. I fixed the bar with a connector block for the tilt mechanic. And also I make a little notch in this bar for the threaded rod. Don't bumps on this bar. And now I have to install the top sled. So this one goes on here. Like so. And I have another one. This comes here. Now I can put this in the slot. Now the tricky thing is to get the threaded rod in the slot. So let's make a test how it works. You see this? Look at this. Yes. It works. No. Now I make by myself some gears. There comes one here and one here. And I go to the front. Why I do this on the side? That's because maybe I want to change something easily. I don't have to put off all the pieces. So let's do this. I fix the first gear for the tilt mechanic. And now I need some mount for this gear. And I come up in the front, and here comes after another gear, and for I go faster, I install a bigger gear for making the tilt. For the another gear, I think I make just a test box that fits in here. And this is the front side from the table saw. It's in a prototype. I make it easy just for test. So this comes like here. This here. Now I have to mount this on here, and I think I use a T-nut to nut and some washers. I think I drill pilot holes for the teeth. So a washer and a nut. Now the gear. And another washer and a nut. Up. So to find the correct place for the gear, it's not so simple. I think let's try this place. It's not smooth. Maybe I have to go a little back. Yeah, it works. It works very nice. So I have to for a smooth slide, but for the moment not so bad, not so bad, not so bad. So I have some like I can work with. So I try this with a cordless driller. It's a bit loud, or you can down the volume on your speaker. I have to tweak some out for it's not so loud. It takes a bit of time to figure out how this gear have to stay with the alignment, but I find a place. This mount is just provisory. I change this after when the saw runs with a nicer one. So, and for the noisy, I have play around a little bit and I have look every teeth, and when it bumps, I just take off a little bit and try again, and this I do with all the teeth, and now I have a smooth run. What I do overnight, I give a couple coats of varnish and some beeswax, so for the moment the whole mechanic works very great. And you can see when I turn the crank, the whole carriage is move. So this is what I want. I want change the direction from the front side. So now I have to do couple little things and I can turn the saw for the first time. Wow. Needs a hole for the cable, for the on-off. Oh. I have to put on this part. So now I can turn the first time the whole saw. You see this? It's my old table saw underneath. Here's it, the first time on the top. So I have a small bow on the tabletop. I don't know why for the moment. Can you see? I have to take care of it. This direction is okay. Just this direction, a small bow. You know why? Maybe. Yeah, I don't know why. But how I take care of this? Maybe I plane the top. Maybe yes. What do you think? I have to play in the top or more reinforcement on the underside? I will see. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. And now I wanna raise up the first time the plate. And it's coming. Yes, that's cool. So, and with a small blade, I can cut 4.5 centimeters. That's more as I need, because I cut just plywood boards, MDF, in the thickness of the hive, maximum 22 mil. So that's all what I need normally. I think I don't need really often a bigger blade. I have one, but the most, that's enough. That's a little bit like a flipper automat. Ding, 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 ding.